We go. Hello, this is video 654. I just wanted to make a video today. I've had a lot of guilt lately. Not guilt necessarily, but I have some friends who are very adamant about going to support group meetings and, you know, kind of to the point of I feel like I've kind of lost their friendship because I don't go anymore. You know, Groucho Marx once said that he wouldn't join a club that would have him as a member. And it's kind of funny, you know, when you say it, when you think about it. But over the course of my transition and post-op life, probably, you know, I'm 2, almost 3 years post-op. And the necessity to go to a support group meeting has just diminished almost to the point of being just, it's almost like a hassle. And I feel like I probably have lost some friends because I don't go, you know. And kind of I come across as being sort of a grumpy individual anyway nowadays, but you know, at face value, the idea of a support group sounds incredible. Group of people getting together, offering an open ear, listening, and providing what support they can. It's cheap therapy if you don't have access to a therapist. It's a good catch-all. I mean, it sounds really awesome. You know, there might be some trans women who are suicidal, very depressed, they're not seeing a counselor, and a support group can be a great catch-all to steer them in the right direction, you know, point them to a therapist, direct them to counseling, to offer some sort of advice, and to, again, like I said, steer them in the right direction, offer support, the idea of, you know, not being alone. If you're coming to terms with being transgender, knowing that you're not alone, I know my own, you know, I thought I was totally fucked in the head for the first 10 years of my life. When I was in elementary school, I had these feelings and I thought there was something wrong with me. And, television and movies provided, you know, these stories about switching bodies with someone or being a doppelganger or a shapeshifter, polymorph, and you change your body and being a woman. I mean, I knew what I wanted to do, but I didn't know what it was called. And it wasn't until I was in middle school that, or, you know, I rode my bike to get my hair cut at a place, and there was an article about a French trans woman, and it opened my eyes to, like, oh my gosh, that's what it's called, that's what I am. And so, you know, I really think a support group is a good thing. For the life of me, I can't tell you why I don't want to participate in it anymore. I don't know if it's the fact that I feel like I'm an old fuck and I go there. I mean, the last support group meeting, the last two support group meetings, give me credit. I went to two support group meetings past when I didn't want to go. And I just needed to confirm my feelings, and I did. And it was just that I have nothing to offer or gain by going to a support group meeting. I just don't. You know, I've seen it all, done it all. It's all been done. Okay. As the Bare Naked Ladies song goes, it's all been done before. And so you would say, well, my goodness, you could give back to the community. You could offer your bad advice and perspective to people, and you know, you would be absolutely correct. But my experience with support group meetings, that's not what happens. And one support group meeting, one group started off kind of small and has gotten kind of big. And when you have 20 to 30 to 40 people in a room, no one's going to listen to my problems. No one's going to give a shit about my problems. You know, basically a quiet voice in the back of the room, and you could say, well, you know, that's your choice. That's your choice. You're choosing to do that, and it's true. So I'd rather spend my time doing something else. You know, so again, I feel bad for that. I feel like I'm doing something wrong. I'm doing a disservice. At the same time, I'm in a different situation. You know, my work schedule right now is very chaotic. It changes from week to week. I don't necessarily have weekends off. When support groups meet, I'm usually working now, but there kind of comes a point when I'm moved on. I'm beyond it. I'm beyond it. And like I said, one support group has got way too many people, you know, and people don't feel comfortable talking about what their problems or whatnot. And so it's, you know, and unfortunately, as an old fuck, you know, you hear someone say something that's so minute, and you just kind of nod your head and you're like, well, you know, this is what you could do, this is what you could do. And again, it's a benefit to them, and it makes you feel good because you're helping the community. But there's threefold the number of me's in the room offering bad advice to young trans women. You know, they don't need me. And over the course of a year or two, you know, I got less and less out of going to a support group meeting. So, you know, I've kind of gone off the idea of going back. That said, I am totally here for anyone who needs support. I'm happy to listen. You know, maybe it's a group thing. You know, I really am. I'm interested in helping people one-on-one and talking to people one-on-one, but I don't want to be a part of a group. I guess I'm anti-group. Pro-individual, anti-group. But I realize that doesn't make any sense. You know, a support group can be a good thing, but it's not really my cup of tea anymore. And I don't necessarily know if it's just because I'm screwed in the head or I'm an old fart or what. But, you know, I can remember a time. Well, this is gonna even make me sound even more like a grumpy old fart. You know, when I was transitioning, you know, participating had a different value. It was alive and could respond better because it was an active part of my life. And now, in many ways, I've moved on. I've progressed to the next level. And I almost hate to say that because then it sounds like there's better and worse and further along and younger and older, and maybe it's true. I don't know. But I highly encourage someone who needs it to do a support group, to be a part of a support group. But I don't know. There comes a time when you move on, and there comes a time when I don't consider myself going stealth or whatever, but I don't want to spend an hour in a room full of people talking about transgender stuff, I guess. You know? It's not how I want to spend my free time. And I hope that doesn't make me any less of a person. I hope I don't lose friends over it. But, you know, again, one-on-one, I'd love to talk to you. I'd love to hear your story. I'd love to help you out any way that I can. But I don't want to be a part of a group. And I can't necessarily explain why. So that's where we're at. Trying to think what else. I've noticed too, and this again is maybe part of what I say, what I think conveys me as a grumpy old fart is, I'm tired of hearing about transgender shit. You know, my Facebook feed is full of trans this and trans that and trans rights and trans support and drag queen shit and gender crap. I mean, maybe again, when I was going through it, it meant a lot. But now I'm like, I don't want to hear about it. I don't want to hear about it. And that makes me feel like a grumpy old fart. But, you know, I'm tired of it. And maybe it's age and stage. Like I said, I don't consider myself stealth, but I'm not going to go to gay bingo night. You know, it just, I don't know, it rubs me wrong. I want to be. And this is really going to make me sound like an old fart. Grumpy old fart. But I want to be in the real world. I want to be in the world. I don't want to be in the gay world. You know? If the objective is equality for everybody. Well, this is going to be a philosophical. You know, yes, I want gay rights. Yes, I want equality for everybody. But the moment that you band together into a group, you have insiders and you have outsiders. And you're against each other. If you're not with us, you're against us. Does that make any sense? Probably not. But like I said, I'm not. I transition to be as much of a woman as I am, as I can be. And I want to be in the world. I want to be plugged into the world. I don't want to be sequestered into a subgroup of that world. I want to experience the world as a whole, not as a subset. And I fear that's probably part of the reason why I don't want to go to a support group meeting. I don't know. I don't know. We all feel differently. But I would much rather meet a trans person for a cup of coffee and talk one-on-one than I would in a group. And, you know, there are definitely people who that's their hobby, that's their interest, that's what they want to do. It's a free country, by all means. And maybe my hope is that as excited and accepted and wonderful as it is to be a part of that, you can also allow me to be as happy, as wonderful, and as excited not to be a part of it. But then it kind of puts me against, and that's not the way I want to be. But like I said, I'm not interested in drag queens, not interested in bingo, drag, I saw a thing. It was and I guess someone was excited enough about it, and I should be happy, but it was a drag queen production of The Wizard of Oz, and all the happiness to you, but the way I look at society and the world now, try to be all inclusive, all, and something like that I have no interest in. But I guess I should be thankful that for groups like that, there is that. But I don't know. I don't know. I have a couple of friends in mind that I'm afraid I may lose over it. But I guess I had to make a comment. Number one, because it's my channel. Number two, because it's an emotion I'm feeling. And number three, I'm kind of curious if I'm alone. If you are happen to be middle-aged and you are post-op or not. Let's say you're full-time 4 or 5 or 6 years and you just don't have an interest in maybe what you used to. Maybe that's just normal. That's just life. I don't know. But, as grumpy old person, I mean, I'm tired of my feed on Facebook. Maybe I need to change my Facebook features or friends. I don't know. But no interest in drag shows. I have no interest in, LGBTQ stuff anymore. I really don't. I want to be a part of the world, but that's me. That's where I'm at. So comment if you're in the same situation, maybe not. How did you, how do you, where are you? Like I said, it probably is only going to be applicable if you've been full time for a couple years. Because we need that community when we're trying to come to terms with who and what we are in the process of transitioning. And again, a part of me is like, well, don't you feel obligated to help? Don't you feel obligated to help the people who are coming behind you? And I would say yes, and I did for a number of years. But now I'm more interested in me. Does that make me egotistical? Does that make me self-centered? Does that make me unappreciative? I don't know. I don't know. It's crazy. It's crazy. I'm kind of wondering if this is just the sense of balance and equilibrium that we get to. For so long we wanted to be part of womanhood, and then we reach it and we want to enjoy it. We want to explore it. Maybe we don't want to be reminded of trans stuff. I don't know. I don't know. It's and it's definitely an individual thing. But I don't know. I don't know. Isn't life wonderful in that we are such a variety of people? And we're not all alike. We're different in some ways. We're like in some, but we're different in some. I guess variety is the spice of life, but I don't know. I'm trying to think of a good word. Well, good name for this video might be retiring. No, not retiring. But just curious. Just curious if I was alone. You are not alone. No one is alone. All right. Till next time. Good luck, my friends. Stay with me. Journey's not over yet. Take care. Good luck in your own transition and your own journey. Bye-bye.